now that the woodwork is done inside the truck, I'm going to start working on the electrical. So the battery's on the inside right now. I'm going to cut out the wood to mount the electrical components to, and then I'll see how well it fits on the inside of the truck. I'm inside the truck right now. So I got the wood cut. I got all the electronic components mounted with the battery next to them. So in the upper left hand corner is where the solar panels will plug into. It's a little breaker box. And then the output from that box will go to the bottom blue box there on the left. That's the MPPT charge controller. So that'll take the voltage from the panels and adjust them so that we can charge a 12 volt battery. And then the large blue box there on the left, that's the Orion smart DC to DC charger, so I can run the cables from the battery up front to this unit and then batteries cables from that unit to this battery here on the right. And then I can charge from my engine while I'm driving. And then the large box in the middle, it's a 2000 watt inverter, 4000 watt peak. And that will be what gives me my AC whenever I need to run anything. And if for some reason the solar panels aren't charging, the black box mounted on the front of the inverter, that's an additional battery charger. I just mount it to the front. So I can, if I need to, I can charge that from the Energy Apex unit that I've been running my circuit saw with. I can use that to charge this battery. Say if I'm in the woods under a shaded tree and not getting any sun, I can put my 5 solar panels out in the sun, charge my Energy Apex, and bring that back over here and charge this battery inside the truck. We'll be mounting the solar panels next. I mounted the brackets to the solar panels. The brackets are sold separately. And I also didn't use the screws that come with them. I upgraded to 1/4-20 bolts with elastic stop nuts. Plus I also am using stainless steel so they don't rust. But they can either go in these holes over here, or there's a third hole here, or you could put them on the sides. This is the bracket. These two little tangs here catch on the side of the solar panel just to make it a little bit more secure. But I also put glue, just having one bolt underneath. I didn't think that was enough. It probably is. But I also put glue, adhesive, GOOP, E6000, they're both about the same, but I put that underneath, let that dry overnight. And now they're ready for mounting. Next I need to mount the solar panels of the roof. I used the Sharpie to transfer the holes to the roof after I got them positioned where I want them. So then I'll have to pull the panels off, I'll drill the holes, and then I'll put them back up. And I have some Dicor sealant that I'll put underneath the brackets to seal the moisture out. These three panels will be wired in series. So I'll have one positive lead and one negative lead that has to go through the topper. So I have an entry gland which has two cord grips on it, so I can go hold each wire individually, and that's underneath this middle panel. So I have to drill a hole through the topper for that also, and then glue that down too. So I marked where the entry gland is going to go. I marked with a black Sharpie all the way around it. then put a dot in the center where I'm going to drill with my hole saw. I'll put a 2 1/4 inch hole in there. And the positive wire will go in one hole, and the negative wire will go in the other hole. Both wires will go through here. And then connect to the gray box on the inside. And this is the cut hole. So it looks like it's insulated, and it's cardboard in there. So it's extra thick. It's probably 3/4 inch thick. I got 1 inch stainless bolts, but I need to get some 1 1/4 inch now. I have all the holes drilled and the panels up on the roof. I'm ready to put the sealant underneath the brackets. This is the sealant. So it's lap sealant, dicor. You hear that term a lot. It's just white, self-leveling. I have all the cables hooked up. I have zip ties holding them in place so they're not just flopping around. The two cables that go through the gland. This had double-sided tape on it. I'm still going to put bolts in there, and then I'll probably put dicor on top of and on the edges. So I'll be doing that first before I do the panels. The bolts, I have a large washer, stainless steel, everything stainless steel. So this will go through the bracket, through the roof, and on the bottom side, I got even a larger washer. And then I have elastic stop nuts, little piece of plastic on the inside. It's like a lock nut. That way I don't have to get it too tight, since there's a gap between the outer topper and then the inside of the topper. I don't want to squeeze it too tight, and I don't want the bolts to come loose. So the elastic stop's perfect for this. So I'm going to start gluing this on and then call it a night. So we got the panels on, the dicor is underneath the brackets, the screws are in, tightened down on the inside. After it stops raining, I'm going to try to put some more dicor on top of the screws to seal them off completely.